On July 9th, 2007, the NAACP, National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, held what looked to be a parade or some sort of social event in Detroit. Hundreds of people gathered around wearing African garbs, African drums in the background, and marching in unison. It was later discovered that a couple of horses were carrying a casket down the main corridor of the city. Wait, what? To my surprise, I realized that this wasn't a funeral at all. This was a social event held to bury not a person, but a word. They were going to bury the word nigger. Nigger. When you take the time to reflect on American history, it becomes pretty obvious why that word is the most heavily researched and debated word with regards to the African American vernacular. It's quite polarizing. I mean, on the one hand, you have those who feel that the word that was originally created to dehumanize black folk was taken and claimed and sort of reconstructed to act as a term of endearment to blacks only. And on the other hand, you have those who feel that the word should be eradicated completely. Well, after reading this book, Navigating the N-Word, How Keeping Niggas Alive is Killing Black Folk, I can understand which side the author Brady Goodwin Jr. has taken. Now, I'll start by addressing some valid points made in the book. I'll mention the opposing argument from a more linguistic perspective. I'll mention my own experience with the word, and I'll talk about how artistry has made an impact for words like nigger to be solidified in language. Let's start with the term of endearment argument. This argument bases its stance on the fact that black folk have now taken ownership of this word while simultaneously telling white folks that they can't say nigger. Here's how the argument plays out in interviews.
Yeah, and you know, I think you and I had this conversation on the phone last week, is it because my children are biracial and they're young and they're trying to figure out how to use words and they have friends of many different ethnicities, of course. My 10-year-old said the other day, well, Mom, if you're not allowed to say the N-word, but Daddy is, what's the rule for me? So what do you tell a multiracial child?
Yeah. Okay, so
Mark, and I didn't
Mark,
really have a good, clear answer.
Black people said it because we moved into this post-racial ideology, this colorblind ideology that says if we don't talk about race, if we don't name race, if we don't speak certain racialized terms, and somehow the world will be racially better, and it's simply not true. I don't have a problem with a sitcom or with you as an esteemed journalist using the N-word in context because it has explanatory value. Do I think that white people should be using it? Absolutely not. Do I think someone with a biracial son should be confused about this? Absolutely not. I always find it remarkable that white people find the N-word usage such a complicated puzzle. It's not that complicated. Just don't use it. You just have to accept that there are some things in the world, just at least one thing, that you can't do that black people can, and that might just be okay.
According to Goodwin, it is impossible to take such a hateful word and flip it to mean something else when the original intent of that word was never intended to carry out such a positive meaning. He goes on to compare the semantic pattern of altering a negative meaning to mean something more positive by addressing the crucifix, an object that was used to aid the death of Jesus Christ. But you have to ask yourself, though, why is the crucifix such an iconic symbol that is associated with Christianity? And the reason why it's an iconic symbol with Christianity today is because we believe that Jesus has resurrected from that grave and is no longer on the cross. This cross is now a symbol of our salvation, our Savior, the risen King. Basically, the term nigger cannot be used as a symbol of overcoming its oppressor because the meaning still oppresses its users. And by users, I mean black folk. He also mentions that the word nigger still reinforces that same dehumanizing intent that the word nigger was created for. Goodwin goes on to say that when nigger is used in a more term of endearment type of way, that's only one of three examples. That example being more of the dependable nigger.
I will do anything you want me to do. My nigger.
But there are two other uses, the expendable nigger and the exceptional nigger. Now, the expendable nigger is used more in the sense of, let's say, a John Doe, a person who has no name and essentially no identity outside of their skin color. Now, the exceptional nigger is almost the complete opposite. This functions as more of a top dog or upper echelon within the black community, you know, for people who use that word. linguistically, I don't think this word can be erased that simply. I mean, especially when you look at the fact that it was created by a whole bunch of racist white folk years ago who believed in this construct and gave it power. Secondly, as mentioned before, this word has too many functions in the African American vernacular to be singled out as simply one word that has one meaning. Furthermore, this word is deeply rooted in hip hop as well. I mean, just listen to the story of OJ by Jay-Z on his new 444 album.
Light nigga, dark nigga, faux nigga, real nigga, rich nigga, poor nigga, house nigga, feel nigga, still nigga, still nigga.
Here you have a story that starts with OJ, an exceptional black man who was rich and successful at the time. Yet during all that press, he didn't want to be considered black, just a man, just OJ. I mean, that's cool and all, but what about the rest of the world's perception of you? Black folks' perception of you? You see, what Jay-Z was highlighting in his chorus was that even in the racial hierarchy in America, there is hierarchy amongst black folk. Yes, you can be rich and live in a more affluent white society, but you are still in the same black caste system within the racial hierarchy. And my final reason for thinking that this word really isn't going anywhere is because it's linked to a larger history exposing the truth about the fact that black existence has been hated for centuries now. Now here's my take on this. I do agree with the author in his assumption that the use of this word can keep black folks in the lower caste system, but I feel as though this book is putting a bit too much emphasis on how we're using this word rather than taking ethnographical data on what music we listen to nowadays, what we African Americans identify ourselves as, what percentage of us actually use the word on a consistent basis, and to whom we use it with. And with regards to race relations, simply not using that word is a defense that a lot of white people use to justify them not being racist. I don't call black people niggers, so therefore I am not and cannot be racist. Nah, doc, it don't work like that. Look, if you're black in America, then you probably felt the venomous sting of that word at some point. As a matter of fact, my eldest brother remembers when he was called a nigger for the first time.
When I was 8 years old, I was playing outside one day with one of my white friends. We got into an argument about something that I can't really remember. After the argument, I asked if I could ride his bike around the block. He said, "No, nigger," and rode back home. Even at 8 years old, I was deeply hurt because I knew that word carried weight when spoken out of the mouth of a white person directly in the face of a black person.
I'll end with this quote by James Baldwin. I believe that this quote captures some of your sentiments. "What you were describing and what you were afraid of was not me. You invented it. It had to be something you were afraid of and you invested me with. If I'm not the nigger, and if it is true that your invention reveals you, then who is the nigger? I give you your word problem back. You're the nigger, baby. It's not me." This has been the Black Curriculum.
Light nigga, dark nigga, faux nigga, real nigga, rich nigga, poor nigga, house nigga, feel nigga.